Hey, game dev enjoyers, PixTrick here. Today, let me introduce you shaders, not the ones used in movies for special effects, but real-time shaders, shaders for games. You probably already have heard about them, making Minecraft look like a AAA game or giving a game a very unique art style. But what is a shader in the first place? A shader is a set of instructions or code that tells the GPU how to render a 2D or 3D object on the screen, depending on a bunch of parameters. These parameters depend on the object itself, such as its position, rotation, scale, normals, and UV mapping, for example, but also on the scene, such as the lighting and the distance to the camera, for example. Commonly, shaders are used for vertex displacement and color computation. On the one hand, vertex displacement stands for the effect of moving vertices. Most of the time, shaders take the mesh info and do a bunch of calculations to place vertices correctly and nothing more. But if we add some offsets in the middle of the calculations, we can deform this mesh. Not only that, shaders also allow you to change these offsets at runtime, which can be used to procedurally animate some meshes, like water for example. Color computation, on the other hand, is the operation of determining the color of each pixel covered by the mesh geometry. This calculation can be affected by many factors, such as the light position and its parameters, or even big mathematical formulas. You can even decide to skip the rendering of some pixels for any reason, and that's basically what is done all the time with the depth and stance buffers. A shader can also take a set of properties to define its behavior, and a given set of properties of a particular shader is called a material. Creating multiple materials from a shader is then a way to create as many sets of properties of a specific shader as you need, like different colors, for example. You can apply a material to multiple objects, and modifying one of the properties of this material will then modify all objects that have this specific material. You can also apply multiple materials to a single object, which will stack the renderings. You can also modify the properties of a material at runtime, which allows tons of cool effects, like liquid wobbling, for example. Anyway, that's all for that small intro in the world of shaders. We barely scratched the surface of the shader iceberg, but we'll go more into details in future videos. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye.